We as beef by the pound. Like you look at, as a matter of fact, you look at like Roc-A-Fella.
Okay.
They probably would drop, let's say, 3 albums a year. You look at Bad Boy, Puff, they probably drop 2 to 3 albums a year. You look at what they did at Murder, Inc.
Around that time.
Probably like drop 3 to 4 albums a year.
That's right.
1998, No Limit, we dropped 26.
It was not a game.
In 1 year.
Yes.
1 year.
I remember.
Wow.
And every.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's like before me, before Manny, they had like Marley Marl.
Okay.
They had, you know, of course, Dr. Dre.
I was gonna ask you, you ever meet him?
Once. I met him once, and it was. Called you because when I met him, I met Dre like right soon as he left Aftermath with the Death Row stuff.
Really?
And we just happened to be in the, working out the same studio. And
so he knew your work and you knew his? And
I don't, as far as Beats by the Pound, people, this is like people first time really starting to see us.
Right.
My turn. That's right.
I told him that earlier. I said, you know what? Like, I knew the song.
Right.
And a lot of people, they know the song, but they don't know who produced it.
Right. Because we.
But they knew who produced Dre's name.
Right. But see, Dre was an artist and people saw
that's
Dre.
That's right. That's right.
And the mm-hmm. thing about with Beats by the Pound, just think about this here. We, as Beats by the Pound, like, you look at, as a matter of fact, you look at. Like Roc-A-Fella.
Okay.
They probably would drop, let's say, 3 albums a year. You look at Bad Boy, Puff, they probably drop 2 to 3 albums a year. You look at what they did at Murder, Inc.
Around that time.
Probably like drop 3 to 4 albums a year.
That's right.
1998, No Limit, we dropped 26.
It was not a game.
In 1 year.
Yes.
1 year.
I remember.
Wow.
And every album.
I remember. That's why I thought we were the best. Like we outworking everybody. No, right. Even to this day, if you put up more content, then I feel like you work. And I tell all the artists that I'm like, it's so easy to put up content. But this guy just said it. They put out a body of work.
Yeah.
And everybody else was just like throwing little. You know,
yeah.
But
you name everybody. You name you. Oh, you look at okay. Just look at Roc-A-Fella, Death Row. No, Roc-A-Fella, Bad Boy, Murder Inc. As a matter of fact, all of those labels, Rough Rider. You put all of those labels work combined for that year. They still and outdo what we did.
That's real.
As one company.
That's real.
And just think about that year. Each album. The least we had on there was 20 songs. So if you kind of calculate, you know, 26 albums with just say 20 songs the least for you, that's about 500, that's over 500 records,
man,
songs.
Y'all playing no game.
And was all of them a hit?
To me?
Yeah.
Like, hell see, yeah, to me.
What No Limit is that.
Like everything like, that went on, Ice Cream Man, all that, everything.
Ice Cream Man.
This is the Ice Cream Man.
Hit the block dressed in white with some baggage of balls.
We made street records. We did like...
I'm from the streets.
We it's like the records that we made became popular with songs that was street records. Like we'll drop like our Miss My Homie type record, but the songs on the album...
Pimp was on that.
Yeah, because it's like...
Well, I'm into it. It's real.
Yeah.
You see how he
I'm serious right. about it.
But see, you look at like all of them songs like No Limit Soldiers.
We know I thought I'd go.
Nigga, I'm busting me low, but I'm hitting them down with jokes.
Make them say,
Make them say,
Down down for my nigga. Good.
Bitch, I'm down with no limit. I ride for the cause. I'm the nigga on the tank with the big
the drum. The drum major. Who gave you that name? Did you give yourself that name?
Fiend gave me that name.
Wow. Okay. That's hot. That's hot. Fiend man, gave Fiend me that was name. A bad boy, man. Look, man. Listen, man. This is what it's all about, man. Like the music, that was real music. You know, I used to be mad at my parents, man. They play that old Al Green or something, or they'll play Frankie, you know. And they were like, "Oh yeah, that why y'all listen? We listen to Too Short, and you know what I'm saying? Yeah, we would listen to some. It was horrible to them, but, and I understand
but
that
you
now.
You know what though? We became them.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.